This is Fox 29 News at 5.
An out-of-control school bus. A dangerous crash. A dozen school kids sent to the hospital. One girl lost a leg. Tonight, the answer to what's to blame and the next step for the families.
Good evening, everyone. Thanks for spending the next hour with us. I'm Carrie Lee Halkett. Our hearts have gone out to Ashley Zoflik since that accident happened, and the community has poured out support while everyone has been waiting for answers. Well, tonight we have some, at least. A report just out on the Pensbury bus crash blames the driver. Fox 29's Claudia Gomez live now in Falls Township. And Claudia, he's at fault, but police have not charged him. Why?
Well, Carrie Lee, they say it was just a mistake. They say that when that bus driver took the wheel of this bus behind me, that he was not under the influence of drugs or alcohol, but he was unfamiliar with the bus. And so they say that he confused the gas pedal with the brake pedal. That is a mistake that that driver still denies making.
It's been the object of intense scrutiny for the past 2 months. Why did bus number 42 speed out of control? And why couldn't the driver, John McCleary, get it to stop before it slammed into a crowd of students at Pensbury High School?
What happened here is Mr. McCleary inadvertently stepped on the gas pedal, the accelerator.
Investigators say it all comes down to this. McCleary normally drove a bus with brake and gas pedals like these. But the day of the accident, his regular bus broke down and he switched to bus number 42, which has pedals like these. Notice the photo on the left. The gas pedal on McCleary's regular bus is much smaller than the brake pedal. But on bus 42...
The brake pedal is virtually the same size as the gas pedal.
It's a theory that I don't think holds water when you look at the fact that earlier that very day, John drove that bus with those pedals and knew how to start it and knew how to stop it.
His lawyer says McCleary is adamant. He practically stood on the brake pedal to try to get the bus to stop. But investigators say witnesses back up their version of events. They say a school security guard had to pull McCleary's trapped leg off the gas pedal. Not only that.
There was no indication that the bus was braking. No one saw any brake lights.
So I'm not an engineer, nor am I a mechanic, but I'm a guy with common sense who knows John McCleary can tell the difference between the gas and the brake. And John has a message for all those kids out there. His foot was on the brake.
The accident injured 20 students on the Pensbury High School campus, nearly killing 17-year-old Ashley Zoflik. She spent weeks in the hospital and lost a leg. Her lawyer says the fault shouldn't just rest on McCleary.
The bus driver error was not the exclusive cause of this accident.
Klein says the pedals on bus 42 are just as much to blame.
The principal problem starts with the configuration, the texture, and the design of the brake pedals themselves.
The Pensbury School District still has 13 buses with that same pedal configuration in service, but seven of them are scheduled to be replaced by newer models later this year. Carrie Lee, when we asked authorities, could another bus driver make that same mistake? They said, yes, it is possible, but it is highly unlikely.
Well, thank goodness it's unlikely. Still, Claudia, how is Ashley doing? She's not been able to return to school yet, has she?
No, she hasn't been. She's still at home recuperating. In addition to losing a leg, her pelvis was shattered, so she is trying to heal enough. It's going to take several more weeks before she can be fitted with a prosthesis.
All right, Claudia Gomez, live in Falls Township. Thank you.
Now, live, CBS 3 Eyewitness News at 11.
Driver error. That is the final ruling from Falls Township Police in their investigation of the Bucks County school bus accident. And now the lawyer for the most critically injured student is talking about where his case stands. CBS 3's Valerie Levesque has the story.
Police in Falls Township have released a report on the Pensbury school bus accident. Tom Klein represents Ashley Zoflik, the most critically injured student in that crash.
We're looking at a length of weeks, not months. When a civil lawsuit will be filed on behalf of Ashley.
That lawsuit will be based partially on the accident report, where police say similarities in the design of the gas and brake pedals led to confusion for the bus driver, John McCleary.
Mr. McCleary inadvertently stepped on the gas pedal, the accelerator. There was nothing reckless about what he did. It wasn't intentional. and we don't intend to charge Mr. McCleary.
McCleary's lawyer reacted.
I'm not an engineer, nor am I a mechanic, but I'm a guy with common sense who knows John McCleary can tell the difference between the gas and the brake, and John has a message for all those kids out there. His foot was on the brake.
The bus involved in the accident was a substitute bus. The picture on the left shows what the pedals look like, but the picture on the right shows the pedals of a bus the driver was accustomed to using.
This report lays the blame at the doorstep of the designer of the braking system for being inadequate and for causing the accident.
Ashley Zoflick's lawyer says he will file a civil lawsuit.
We'd be looking principally at the manufacturer of the bus and the brake manufacturer. We are most interested in a number of issues, including the pedal configuration, which apparently the investigators today said was the root cause of the incident.
Now, in addition to the manufacturer of the school bus and the brakes, Ashley's lawyer will also be looking at litigation against the bus driver himself, as well as the school district. Ashley's family already has substantial medical bills that are expected to grow as she continues her rehabilitation. Larry, Lisa, back to you.
All right, thanks, Val.
Other news happening this morning. Police say a Bucks County school bus driver slammed on the gas pedal instead of the brake last month, and the crash injured 20 high school students, one critically. And 17-year-old Ashley Zoflick had her leg amputated. He's now recovering at home. The bus driver, 54-year-old John McCleary, will not be charged. Joining us now to talk more about this unusual tragedy is Ashley Zoflick's attorney, Tom Klein. Good morning to you, Tom.
Good morning.
All right, what was your initial reaction to the judge's ruling in this?
Well, it wasn't a judge's ruling. The police department in this case had completed their investigation. The Falls Township Police Department completed their investigation. They were looking at the bus along with the NTSB. They concluded that the configuration of the pedals was different than this driver might ordinarily have expected, certainly in his ordinary bus, certainly in many other commercially available buses. And so what they ended up saying was, the way I read it, the root cause was a pedal configuration which was inappropriate, which led to driver error. That is one of the theories that we're now investigating. My job is to conduct an independent investigation and to either confirm or build upon what the Falls Township Police Department came up with here.
Your initial reaction to the investigation, though, do you think it was driver error? Do you think it was mechanical error? What do you think's behind this?
My initial view, subject to obviously an awful lot more work and very likely litigation and investigation into how the bus was designed and how the bus was thought out in terms of the pedal configuration, which is much different than many commercially available buses. My initial view is that it is a plausible theory. The bus driver is denying that he had his foot on the gas pedal. There is some physical evidence which apparently leads the police department to that conclusion, namely that his shin was injured, and that would mean where the damage came into the bus, that he likely had his foot on the gas pedal and was confused. If that's the case, then the driver error was really caused by the root cause, what I like to think of the root cause of the problem, which was the failure of the bus to be properly designed. Well, there's a second problem here that the police looked at, which was we're all accustomed to having to put our car in gear after we put our foot on the brake. It's called brake interlock. This bus did not have a brake interlock system, which also may have compounded the problem. Again, a manufacturing defect error rather than driver error.
All right, Tom Klein, we appreciate your views this morning. Thank you.
Nice to be here.